So I went to Loyola Marymount, which is in Los Angeles. And the number one reason I chose that school, well, there's two reasons. Number one is my dad was a professor at Marquette. So that meant at that time I had free tuition to lots of Jesuit universities around the country. The second reason I chose Loyola Marymount literally is because it's right on the beach. So I thought I'd be, you know, picking up all the California babes. That didn't happen. But there's my answer. Yeah. Yeah, so never leave that option to an 18-year-old boy. Because there's a lot of, you know, other areas that I could have investigated too, but I was drawn to the beach.
I'm going to Arizona State University in the fall. I chose it because it has a great business school. I have family that goes there and went there. I'm familiar with Arizona, and it just seems like a great environment to grow in.
So do you have family that lives there now?
No, we did used to live there, but my brother is at college there.
I'm going to Concordia University in Mequon. Just like location, like I said earlier, like being close to home, and it was like cheaper, and just less money.
Okay.
Nice. When looking for colleges, what were the largest deciding factors?
Location, the rigor of the business school, family for sure, and weather.
And did location affect your decision? So I know you mentioned weather.
Yeah, I wanted to be warm, so it did.
Nice. Not cold Wisconsin.
Yeah, no. Never.
Okay. My dad used to spend a lot of time in Mequon, so he said, like, you should go there. It's nice. Like, some of my friends were like, yeah, you should play basketball. Like, you should go there and play.
And to what extent did education drive your decision?
I would say it drove it pretty far. I mean, all the schools that I applied to and got into all seemed to have the same rigor of the business school. Mm-hmm. So all of my options were obviously very good, but this just had the most like financial help and the best choices. But education was a big part of it.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't want to go to just the school just to play basketball. I still wanted to get my education so I can get a good job and stuff, but they also got like a new, because I'm going into business, so they got like a new business like wing, a little new business area, so like I like that a lot, so I thought that was cool.
Not really, no. I liked the academics, so at Loyola Marymount, classes were torn up. You were taught by your professor. And I think professors have written books and they're well known throughout the country. And you could get a, you know, they invite you to barbecues and stuff. I mean, it was really cool. So that I liked. And so that's probably why I'm a history teacher. The reason why I enjoyed it so much is because I had that connection, small class, right with the professor.
Were the students and or teachers politically socialized toward one way or the other, and did that influence your decision?
The university itself, the political socialization of the average student was probably center right, more right than left. So it was very interesting in the sense that people had different views and different things that would go on. So Loyola Marymount, religion primarily Catholic, because it is a Catholic university. To Los Angeles, about a third of the population of the kids who go there are Hawaiian. So, and I never knew, so I had two roommates from Hawaii, and they were both named Kimo. And Kimo is James in Hawaiian, so it's like Jim. I had no idea of the Hawaiian. My two other roommates were the children of Mexican immigrants. By diversity, I mean, I really saw a world that I never knew, and I didn't plan it. I had no idea that that was going to be the case. Now, there were a lot of folks, you know, also coming from the suburbs of California, mainly in California. Like, I think myself and one other person was from Wisconsin in the entire college.
Did the sport reputation of the school impact your decision based on wins or the division?
I'm not going to lie. I really didn't know a lot about Concordia. But I like the coaches, and they actually did really well this year. So, like, that was good to see. So,
I think, so a second example of a sports team would be Marquette. Where I went to Marquette, and it was kind of, it was right after the Jeffrey Dahmer years. And so it was getting a little sketchy, you know, around, like, everybody had this kind of, you know, it was a good university, but it was getting a bad reputation. All of a sudden, Dwayne Wade starts to play for the Marquette University basketball team. And Dwayne Wade is Dwayne Wade, right? And all of a sudden, Marquette, I mean, alumni donations and admissions went skyrocketing. Why? Because of Dwayne Wade made them a nationally known team. I mean, they made the Final Four. So at that school, it was really important. Loyola Marymount, important, but not quite as much. Well, I mean, I would say in your generation and in the last 10 years, for mine, it was no stress. Like, there was zero stress. It was like, well, I guess I'll go to Madison. Like, that's how I approached Madison, you know, and my friends. There was very little competition. Like, I got to get into this particular school. Also, the cost was much lower. Today, you go to college, it's like buying a house. I mean, the loans you have to take out are just ridiculous. So, and the pressure, you know, to do well and to achieve is, you know, highly there. Some of it, I don't know, is manufactured. You know, I don't know if we, the school, manufactured. At the end of the day, you want to go to a school where you're going to like living, right? In my opinion, you're going to like living, you're going to like the people, because wherever you go, I will tell you, your roommates, you know, geography is everything. The people you know in college are even the ones who live in the dorm near you. We're just chatting.
What do you think the most influential factor in current high schools choosing a college is?
I think people today, though, it's driven by, you know, what's this college? How is this going to help me for my future? Whatever I want to study or whatever I want to be. And helping in two ways. Number one is training. Number two is, okay, what's the access to the network that I get? Whoops, right? Sometimes that's more important. Like, if I go to Harvard, I'm going to have that whole network of Harvard people. So I think those are the two things. I think parents are much more involved in the college process, so that could be another factor, than they were in my year. Totally more involved. Because of the cost, you know, because they're paying. We were paying, so go to class.
What is the relative importance of sports when choosing a college?
Boy, that is a good question. So for me, it was minimal. But I think what I've seen and what I've heard is that's one of the key factors today is, like, you know, do they have a Big Ten football team, right? My daughter, who went to SLU, did not. They didn't have one. They had a relatively good basketball team, but they don't have that, you know, Saturday morning walk to the stadium that they have in Madison. I mean, that is a big deal, I think, for students.